You've seen the best, but now, let me show you the rest. Canadian Goose Studios reviewing Ma Rainey's Black Bottom. Long name, I know. So Ma Rainey's Black Bottom just came to Netflix a couple of days back, December 18th, whenever that is. Anyways, it stars Chadwick Boseman, Viola Davis, Taylor Page, Coleman Domingo, Glenn Turman, and Michael Potts. The story behind this is the tensions start to rise when trailblazing blues singer Ma Rainey and her band gather at a recording studio in the Chicago of 1927. Another Chicago movie. Except this one ain't my favorite of the year. Anyways, I do like this one a lot, and all the details on that are, because, come on, the cast is incredible. But it's not just the cast that's incredible, it's like, The Devil All the Time had a great cast, not every single one of them was great, but in this movie, every single one has their spark, especially Chadwick Boseman, who I believe should get nominated for Best Actor, and should win for Best Actor. He was absolutely phenomenal in this film. It was just so weird because, you know, he was happy, he was all making all these jokes at one point, and then the next point he's like, I don't understand what my life was like. It was like that, but he was absolutely incredible as it is. It just went to all these different levels inside this movie, and I just love it. I feel like they could have made this movie a little bit longer, like maybe 30 minutes, so it was 2 hours longer, because, you know, right at the end, they kind of just started bouncing off the walls with all these different plots all coming together, and it just felt a little bit too quick to process everything, and you'll probably have to look it up when, in most movies, you shouldn't have had to look up after you watch them. Usually you will, but for this one, I feel like if they just extended it, you wouldn't have had to look anything up, but you do, so. I feel like this movie has a big chance of getting nominated for Best Picture in the Oscars, just because it feels so unique from any other Netflix film we've seen, because it takes place in one space, kind of like The Hateful Eight or Death Proof, I believe. Yeah, it just felt like it took place in one area, and that was that area, and it was so good. There were some scenes that were funny, some scenes sad, some dramatic scenes. It was such a great film, such a great film. This is an interesting movie because it's historic, but in the way of it, historic, I knew nothing that this happened. Like, same with the trial of Chicago 7, I knew nothing about that. So I knew nothing about this movie either. I had no clue what I was going into. I thought that it was gonna be like a, kind of like a movie like Green Book. I thought it was gonna be kind of like a movie like Green Book, you know, like they're just going to different areas, making jazz, you know, they get in some dramatic situation and all hell breaks loose. I thought it was gonna be like that, but it turns out it was much different and much more like characteristic, because you get to learn about the characters inside of this one area. You learn every single one's name, their story, their history, their family. It's just so good. One problem I have with this movie and many other films in the Netflix universe, I'm gonna call it now, well, just in the Netflix category, when they release a new film, they all feel like the same with their color and their saturation. I don't know, it's just, is it to me? Because they all have the same like colorization on them, like Extraction looks similar to like Five Bloods looks like Devil All the Time, looks like Trial of Chicago 7. Trial of Chicago 7 looks like Ma Rainey's Black Bottom. It's just, they all feel really similar to one another. And sadly, I haven't seen a movie yet out there that is like quite different from each other. But you know what? I still like every single one of those movies, right? I like every single one. I just feel like they need to switch it up. And I think The Midnight Sky coming out, like, couple of days from now, it's gonna change that. don't think it's gonna be good, but I feel like it's gonna look different at least. So anyways, I don't wanna keep you guys here watching me talk about a movie that you probably will never watch and never ever heard of until the Oscars come up. But anyways, my score for this movie will be a solid 82 out of 100. My 8th favorite film of the year, don't worry. My top 10 favorite films of the year will be coming soon, but this is my 8th so far. Tell me your score if you even seen this movie down in the comments down below. Share your thoughts on this film, and can't wait to see you in the next video.